This trailer is a few years old, and it's going through a transformation. Got new siding on the walls. It's going to have cabinets up front. Floor prepped, ready. Thank you.
working on a slope has its challenges. So now we'll ease it back. Check in our relief cuts, make sure we don't move too much. How's the tape line up there? Pretty good? So then we give it a roll, kind of roll it the lengthways first, try and get as much of it in the glue. Work out some of the, it's been unrolled for a few days, but it still has some memory of the rolled up from the factory. These tools are same as for sheet vinyl or other glued down products. We'll get this first half in it and work out any extra adhesive. It started to stick. Glue the other half and then make sure it's adhered and trim it in. The edges all get trim around the step and at the back. It's gonna be rubber base around the on the walls. There's cabinets going in the left corner. One way or another, all of the edges will be held down so they don't get kicked loose or curl up over time. Thank you. pull back the other side.
There we go.
in?
I'll wait till we get done there. Walk all over it once like we did last time.
Left it a little long here at the step in case it needed to move around a little bit. Again, it gets a trim that's about a half inch or inch. Covers. Edge and keeps people from kicking it loose. little short of the wall is better than too tight, because it, it'll expand and contract a bit. And it's a trailer, so as it's going down the road with a race car in it, it's gonna bounce around and a little room for some movement. Is good. And there's a trim that went on here last time that was about an inch, so cut it pretty close. I don't know if he's gonna put that back on or if the rubber base is gonna go on, and that hides about a quarter inch, so. And some people will make a template and have this all cut and ready to go and just bring it in and unroll it. Trim it in place. This knife, it's a sheet vinyl knife. Blade doesn't retract. This way, you just keep trimming away until you get it. Where it's not being held up. Use a little, this is a sheet vinyl seam roller for some little spots that need some extra pressure. I'm using a heat gun to warm it up if it's got a stubborn spot. It's probably gonna be happening soon. Might be a little full there still. Yeah. This FRP is up. There's room underneath it, so it can go slide underneath there fairly easily. Cut this short, we left it long. Easier to trim it. Replace if it shifts a little or goes under the wall. This FRP went over a wood siding that was also up off the floor a bit. Places. Have lots of blades. This stuff likes to eat the blades. I don't know if it's the abrasive in the small coin pattern or if these other patterns . Probably best to have plenty of blades on hand no matter what you're doing. But this is a popular floor because of the traction. Resistance. Seems to have a few bubbles in it this way still, so I just
I'm trying to work these ones out that were up there.
Thank you.
down.
Let me roll it this way. Yeah, I kind of started about the fenders and worked this way. Yeah, like come that way and yeah, from about there and push this way. Might need the heat gun to warm it up a little.
See it up there?
Yeah, go a little slower.
Okay.
And stop on some, if there's a bubble, stop on it. Rubbed my knuckle loose. Knock some skin off. So once it's all cut in, not being held up anywhere, it'll be easier to get it to lay down flat. If you've got some stubborn spots, you can put weight on it, toolbox or something that'll put some pressure on it. Go slow and work it that way. Is it too tight along here anywhere? Thank you. light anywhere else? Thank you. Now we warm it up and mix it a little bigger for a socket, and then as it cools down, gets the glue.
Got a little tricks to the trade, huh?
So this part of the trailer, we're installing the custom-made Steve Huff Motorsports logo on the G-Floor mat. So G-Floor, you cannot put your logo for your race team, your sponsors, whatever you're licensed to have them put on the flooring. That's a great way to cause you're racing. So Steve's gonna have his electric dragster in here for the most part, but he also races motorcycles and other things, so who knows what's gonna be in here. You have to follow him for that. The plan with this tailgate door is he wants diamond plate on the sides, and it's gonna have a trim of some sort, so we'll put this piece on. Roughly in line with the rest of the floor. It's the same floor, it's just this one has to go on it. And get some pictures of it when it's all done. So this one we're gonna also fold over side to side. It's marked to help keep it. It's a smaller piece for shift. Out and ready to go. I'm just going to finish, you know, so it's cured.
coolest trailer at the track. Get your own custom floor. In all these colors and styles. That's the one we got here. Custom logo. So the G-floor's been done for a day on the tailgate and 2 days inside the trailer. We put some scrap on the sides. It's gonna get diamond plate over the top. Just wanted to give it same level so that when the diamond plate is overlapped, it'll sit flat. And it's gonna have trim around the edges. So none of the trim, metal trim has been done yet, but rubber base on the walls, that'll help keep the edge down and make it easier for cleaning and maintenance. Light makes it look like it's got a bunch of rolls in it. Again, there's gonna be new metal or refurbished along this door edge. It's got built-in cabinets that are sitting on top of it, rubber base between cabinets and the fender. So there it is. Makes a great trailer floor, just in time for race season.